Well, I want to welcome our guests today, Judi Singley, who's the Associate Dean of Health Occupations at GCC. And she oversees the massage therapy program, the paramedic program, our two nursing programs, and comes to us from a background of wellness and therapeutic recreation. So Judi, I'd like to start with you and your role here at GCC.
Here at GCC, I'm the Associate Dean for Health Occupations, and at Greenfield Community College, we have two nursing programs, an LPN, Licensed Practical Nursing Certificate Program, and Associate Degree Nursing Program, Massage Therapy, as well as EMS, Emergency Medical Services, which includes all levels of emergency medical service work, EMT Basic, all the way up through our Paramedic Certificate Program.
Great. And how did you come to be an Associate Dean in Health Occupations?
Well, the first thing is a disclaimer. I am not a nurse. How could that happen? How could I be in charge of the Health Occupations programs and not be a nurse? It's interesting, my pathway for getting here and in my presentation, I'm gonna talk you through that. So maybe I should just roll with that and how I ended up getting involved in working in healthcare in an allied health occupation, as well as how I ended up here in education. So I'm gonna roll through right here. So way back when, at first I wanted to be a wildlife biologist. I was gonna go out and save the bears and the whales and study them and do all kinds of things. And I thought that that would be absolutely the best career for me. And so I went to UMass to study wildlife biology, and then I didn't meet up with a grizzly bear. I met up with chemistry. Chemistry was nearly the death of me as an 18-year-old starting out in college. I'd been a good, strong high school student, but really got overwhelmed in a huge university, a lecture hall of 400 students, and chemistry. And so that did me in. And it scared me. It scared me enough to go quickly looking for and trying finding another major. Well, because I had a big love for being in the out of doors, I thought that, wow, parks and recreation, that would be cool. And at UMass at the time, there was a leisure studies and resources degree program, which had parks and recreation in it. So I started out taking the courses in outdoor recreation and all of that. But as part of that curriculum, you had to take courses about recreation in other parts of a career path as well, too. And that's where I became involved with and interested in community-based wellness and fitness. So I started out wanting to be a wildlife biologist. By the end of 4 years, I was graduating from UMass with a degree in leisure studies and resources, but a focus on community-based wellness. Still never had any idea that I would set my foot anywhere near people in real health occupations, or in a nursing home, or in a hospital, or something like that. I changed my major 4 times in the course of my first 3 semesters at UMass, just to reassure you that it's okay to search and explore and change your mind if you need to. So my first professional position was at the YMCA here in Greenfield. I was responsible for a women's and girls physical programming. This was, all right, back in the 1980s, and it was called Women's and Girls Physical Director was the name of my position. I had little kids in the pool with swimming lessons. I had Sherry and her daughter in my class as a mother-daughter baby-parent swim program. But I also was working with elders. They came to an aquatic fitness class. And as much as I loved working with all different populations, I really, really enjoyed working with the seniors. But again, remember, these were well seniors, relatively well seniors, living in their homes and coming and participating in wellness programs at the YMCA. So I really liked the elders. I worked there for a while, and as I worked there, some of the elders, some of the well seniors that were coming to my classes became unwell. That's part of aging, you know, and disease can be a part of that process. So some of the participants I had in programs were ending up in hospitals, in nursing homes, in terms of meeting their health challenges. And that then opened up some doors for my thinking about, well, do I need to just stay in community-based programming? How else might I be able to work with elders? So I became interested in community-based activities programming, all kinds of activities programming, not just wellness-based, but music and dance and all kinds of things, and went to work in an adult day health center. At the time, it was called the Elder Day Care Center here in Greenfield. So again, I was working with elders who were living in their homes or in homes of family members, but needing some kind of care and programming during the day, so they came to a day program Monday through Friday. What I really enjoyed about this position is I had the first opportunity to work with people from other parts of the allied healthcare team. There was a nurse, there was a physical therapist who came in, there was an occupational therapist who came in, there was a speech therapist who came from time to time to work with some of the participants if they were recovering from a stroke. So I started to see, wow, there's this whole team here that you could work with. This was in the early 80s still, and we were just starting to understand what dementia and Alzheimer's was all about. So this program started to take in more and more participants who had some severe cognitive loss issues, some real challenges. I was intrigued with it. Worked there for a while and said, I want more. I want more of this. So went on to work at the Farron Care Center, which is right here in Turner's Falls. Used to be a hospital, but now it's a facility, kind of like a nursing home. But all of the residents who were there also have a mental illness diagnosis as well, too. And so at that point, I'd worked long enough in the field, and I moved up to a director position. Okay. Any questions about that so far? So my career path then, how did I end up here at GCC? Well, when I was working at the YMCA and then in adult daycare and then in long-term care, there was a recreation and leisure services program here at GCC, and I was invited to come in as a guest speaker from time to time. So when an opportunity opened up for me to come as a part-time teacher, I grabbed it. I loved working with participants, but what I really loved is working with people who wanted to work with elders as well, too. So I started here as faculty part-time, then full-time. And then an opening came in the health occupations area, and I was asked if I might be interested in coming over as an interim associate dean, and my first response was, but I'm not a nurse. I'll let the nurses speak to, speak to that. They said the same thing. We don't want a nurse over here. But the fact that I had worked in allied health, the fact that I had worked in long-term care settings, day programming, and worked with a variety of people on the healthcare team, it gave me some exposure to bring to leadership in these programs here. So my educational pathway, what did I need to do in order to get where I was? For starters, I did that bachelor's degree in leisure studies and resources at UMass. I don't think they have the program there anymore under that title. It kind of got carved up and went in different places. But that was the title of it, and it incorporated parks and recreation, therapeutic recreation, and community-based wellness programming. And remember, I ended up working in a therapeutic recreation setting, but I started out parks, then went to community-based wellness programming and ended up here. During the time that I was working in the field, I continually participated in workshops and seminars to stay current. Also, and I'm going to show you this in a little bit, there's a couple of different pathways into working in activities programming, and it required me to be taking workshops and seminars to maintain certification as an activity professional. Some particular areas that I was always interested in were dementia, MIMI, which is medically ill, mentally ill, that combination population, and pet therapy. Big, big interest. And so because I then came to GCC and was teaching, I wanted to become better as a teacher. And so I pursued a master's degree in education with the focus on college teaching at UMass. In terms of wellness programming, I wanted to just share with you. This is Ball State University. It's got one of the most comprehensive web pages for people interested in working in wellness programming. Here's online resources. There is the American Academy of Kinesiology and Physical Education. When I started out in wellness programming, it was community-based. I got interested in elders and wanted to work with well and not so well elders. But if I were interested in becoming certified as, if I wanted to be certified as an exercise specialist, a fitness trainer, there would be different career, a different educational paths that I would need to follow beyond my bachelor's degree or in addition to my bachelor's degree. So you can see there's links there for athletic training. There's links for the American College of Sports Medicine. You can go to each of these links if it's something that interests you, whether it's strength training, it's exercise programming, and see, well, what is it that I need for a degree? One thing that's a little different about some of these parts of allied health compared to nursing is that you can enter through a lot of different pathways. I entered into therapeutic recreation with elders, but through a community wellness loop. Click on YMCA careers. I began my career in the YMCA, and it was fantastic. My position had me working with people of all populations. This is a link to the YMCA's careers, and if you click on health and fitness,
just provides a little bit of explanation about what are the kinds of things in terms of community-based health and fitness programming you could do at the YMCA. If you go back one, you can come down to YMCA sports. You know, organizing the YMCA soccer league was not my thing, so I got involved in other kinds of programming, but there's all kinds of opportunities to work in the YMCA. We're fortunate to be in this area because the college that really has the link with the YMCA's, kind of the YMCA trainers or educators college, is Springfield College, just to the south of us. So they have a wonderful program, a whole lot of majors that are would help you to prepare to work in community-based wellness programming. If you remember, I mentioned I did my bachelor's degree and then did some continuing education. I took a lot of short courses and seminars that Springfield College offered. They were a great resource for furthering my education. So that's just some directions or pathways around wellness programming. So how do you get into it? Again, it's not like nursing where you have to sit for a particular, you take a course of study, get into a program, complete the courses, and sit for an exam, but there's ways to get into it. We have here at GCC a health, wellness, and fitness liberal arts option, which is specific and gives you courses specific to health and wellness programming and prepares you to transfer into a health and wellness program, for instance, at Westfield State. We have a nice articulation agreement with them. Most times you can enter the field and be doing some work in wellness programming with an associate's degree, but if you want to be able to move up within that field, you probably want to be working towards a bachelor's degree as well as working towards certification through one of those professional associations listed on that previous website. So keep going. Okay. So therapeutic recreation. For me, I ended up in the TR field, if you will, as an activities programmer working with elders. The education that I got and the additional certifications that I got were fine for working with seniors. But therapeutic recreation is a huge field, and I have something I just want to share with you today. Again, you're going to, on the handout I'll give you, you have a link to this page. It's all about TR. And Jeannie, if you scroll down, there's a wonderful video on YouTube. This is just going to flash through and show you some different things that recreation therapists do. It's kind of hard to read there, but this guy works as an outpatient rehab counselor. Close your eyes. The next person coming along here works like I did in senior programming, but her focus is particularly on music and dance. Things like art therapy, dance therapy, music therapy. This person is a dance and movement therapist. Work with a dance movement therapist in psych settings as well as community. This person here works with special education programs, the school system sometimes employs. Any of you familiar with the Outward Bound program? Have you heard about that? Okay, those are recreation therapists who help to take kids who are at risk out of their city environment into the wilderness, challenge themselves personally. Aquatic therapists. Inpatient rehab. So, recreation therapy is you have a link to this website on your page here. Gotta watch the YouTube flick that says, I'm going to major in recreation therapy. It's very funny, very well done by a student majoring in recreation therapy at a university. I just wanted to talk a little bit about what I loved the most in terms of activities programming with elders. You know, I think to be successful in any allied health career, you need to like people and want to work with people. I didn't think that I really liked older people. I think I was probably kind of afraid of them. But then when I started to work with them in the pool at the YMCA and hear their stories and listen to their lives, I got comfortable with them. And what I learned each day that I worked with older people was that they're people too. They're just like me. They have the same wants and needs and desires. And just because they're at the end of their life and their bodies or their minds are failing them, they are so interesting and so wonderful to work with, and so incredibly appreciative of the love and the care that you bring to them. So that really just warmed my heart. And you know, I gotta say, working with the patients with Alzheimer's was incredibly challenging, but the staff was great. We had great laughs, not at the expense of the participants afterwards, but just trying to like, can you believe this happened today? You know, or strategies that we would use. As an example, when I was at the Elder Day Center, We had a resident with Alzheimer's who had been a local music teacher here at one of the high schools. And he really wasn't sure why he was coming to the day program. His the disease had progressed enough that he didn't quite recognize family members, didn't quite recognize that he was at a day program. There was a piano. If we got him redirected to the piano, he was great, he was fine. Even though he could not identify his wife, when they pulled in the direction or the route they took coming to the day center, it must have passed by the high school. Something clicked for him. And this was before there were locked doors and barriers and whistles that went off when you opened up a door. And so there were many a day when this gentleman would escape. Has anybody seen Charles? No one's seen Charles. So one of the staff members would go running and looking for Charles. Well, what we soon figured out was he was trying to leave the day program because he needed to get to the high school to teach his class. He was on a beeline to the high school. He couldn't tell you what he had for breakfast, couldn't recognize his wife, didn't recognize his kids, but this was his job and this is what he needed to do. We made a connection with him through recreation programming to help him be happy, to help him be fine. So it's one of my fun stories about what I connected with. Pet therapy was a real big deal for me as well too. I love animals, I love dogs. During the time that I was raising my kids, but working here, I continued to stay involved bringing some pets to local nursing homes. And I tried to find a picture of it for you today, but I couldn't. My dog, Pearl, had puppies at one point, and she had been visiting in a particular nursing home all along. The residents couldn't wait for the arrival of Pearl's puppies. And when they came, we brought the puppies to visit with the residents. And that was probably one of the brightest moments of my life, because the residents just reminisced about their experiences with pets and the meaning that they held for them in their lives. So, how to get there in terms of working in activities. If you want to work in long-term care or day programs, it's pretty wide open. You don't have to have a specific degree, but starting out with an Associate of Arts or an Associate of Science in a related field, our health science option here, which many of you are listed as a major in health science right now, gerontology, recreation, human services, is usually enough to get started in the field. There's a certification process. Again, I have a link to the website for how do you get certified on the handout that I'm going to give you. The doors that opened for me being certified as an activity professional were fine. It was where I wanted to work. Had I wanted to go and work in outpatient or in a behavioral, other types of settings, I might have needed to go on or go back to school for me in that case to get a bachelor's degree and become a certified therapeutic recreation specialist. So it depends on what you want to do to figure out what doors you need opened to you to get there. So,
thank you.
That's it.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So I'm wondering if students have questions for Judi. Well, I have a question.
Okay.
I'm wondering about challenges that you encountered in your career, or challenges that people may encounter now that the population is aging, healthcare is shifting.
I think one of the biggest challenges that I faced in the work that I did in healthcare was trying to figure out what's the right certification, what's the right credential you needed to do the job that you were going to do, because it's one that was pretty wide open. As I mentioned, nursing, physical therapy, occupational therapy have very specific prescribed pathways. So the good side of it was the doors were flung wide open for me to look for ways to come into the field. The challenging part was trying to figure out, what do I need? What do I need for a certification? But you can get those answers by going to the websites, by getting information about the different professional organizations. I think the other big challenge that I face, and I think Jeannie's going to be talking about it later this semester, is about burnout. You know, caring for people, you get tremendous reward back, but it takes a lot out of your heart and soul, too.
Mm-hmm. Any other questions?
Yeah. Caring for people who are in distress, in some form of stress, is stressful. But it's that caring and that giving that I think is wonderful. What I always enjoyed in terms of my role in the allied healthcare team is I was the person who was bringing joy to the patient or to the resident. No offense to the nurses, but I wasn't bringing the medication. I mean, we're all part of a team to help residents feel good. But I got to connect with families. I got to connect with the residents in a way that was hopefully bringing some joy to their life. But you're absolutely right. You got to find a way to create place for balance in your own life. So my love for parks, recreation, and being in the outdoors has never changed. And that's a really important part of my life. I'm an avid biker, road cyclist, not biker, not vroom vroom, biker. hiker, backpacker. I love to be in the outdoors, and I'm there as much as I can. So, a good question.
Do you think you're pretty much in the ideal position now for like your careers or anywhere you want to go from here, or anything that you'd like to maybe do in the future that was along the same lines, or maybe
you make
different?
Me feel so young. I love it. I am. You know, it was a great opportunity for moving into education because I liked to have an impact on patients and residents and people that'll be served through the people who are preparing to go on and do that work. So that's really been great for me. I think, you know, in recreation wellness programming, you're always a little bit of a teacher. And so then I moved here to be a teacher and then moved into administration where my support is for the teaching faculty. So I think so. Sometimes you have to carve your own path. But I think the skills that I got in terms of people skills, understanding people, good organizational skills, managing stress, thinking about the whole person has really helped me to go in whatever direction I want to go. I don't know where I'm going next.
Thank you.
All right.